Good morning, good morning. Merry day after Christmas. Happy Boxing Day.
Oh, is that?
It's Boxing Day today.
Like the actual?
No, it's like a Canadian holiday.
Oh.
Well, we were reading up on it yesterday.
Actually, my family is from Canada.
Okay, so you should know about it and you don't. So we are doing a fun special post-Christmas madness. If this is your first time watching, my name is Shelly Keller. I'm an elite leader within my industry. This is my good friend and cousin-in-law, Ryan. He is going to do my face today, so this could be interesting. But he's very artistic, so
buckle up, guys. This is going to be crazy.
I have a feeling it could be okay. I think you're going to do fine.
Yeah.
He was looking at some bold colors, though, so I'll be interested to see what he goes with. Ginger wants to say hi.
Hi, Ginger.
I don't know why she's insisting on.
I'll tell you guys. Right now. I'm a very big fan of Shelly's live feeds.
So
I'll be at home. I'm going through Facebook and I see this girl's on and I'm like, grab a cup of coffee,
sit and chat,
watch what's up with Shelly, hear what's in her life, see this beautiful face just transform into an even more beautiful face. So I came over today and I'm like, let's do it.
Yeah, he's like, so what are we doing today? And I had my makeup one from yesterday. I was like, we're getting the day after Christmas makeup look going on. That's what we washed it off and we're a fresh start. And I said, now you get to see the real tired, exhausted, and aged-looking face.
Yeah.
We're going to make it look a little bit better.
Okay, so. Aged-looking face. Very, very old. So old. So I've got my...
He's wearing some swag.
And mind you, I have never done makeup in my life. So this would be fun for me and a little scary for her.
I said, it's makeup. It washes off. So even if it's, like, crazy and wacky, it washes off. If it turns out good, we'll just keep it on all day. We'll see.
Take screenshots. Blackmail. Blackmail pictures for the future.
There we go.
Do that.
Oh, right. I almost forgot to say, if you're catching us on the replay, comment, hashtag. Do you know what to comment? You say you watch. Come on, you should know that.
Oh.
Caught.
Strong
and beautiful.
Strong and beautiful.
Hashtag strong and
beautiful.
We're all strong
and beautiful.
If you're catching the replay. Don't forget your brushes there.
All right. I gotta make myself look.
I don't think that helped.
That didn't help. Listen, we were just saying, girls, y'all have it a lot better.
Yeah.
Because this is what you get with a guy. You see it, this is it.
I mean, you can wear makeup. It's just usually a little weird.
And that, well, listen, it's not weird.
No, it's just a little.
It'll be weird on me, for sure.
But you know what? It takes time. Like, it takes time to put makeup on. You just wake up looking awesome. I wake up, oh, I look tired.
Okay, well, I need 20 minutes. Pay her to say that.
It takes 20 minutes to get myself together.
Is it 20 minutes?
Sometimes. Okay. Depends.
Well.
If it's a mom face, it's 10 minutes. Okay.
So, I did get a prep beforehand, so I know a little bit about what I'm about to do to Shelly.
What did you call my makeup collection? You said it's appropriate that these are called...
Oh, yeah.
Addiction.
The addiction collection. Because what you don't see, guys, because I'm a fan of Shelly. So I always wondered, like, what's going on down there? There's a whole
it's like a collection. Whole layer.
There's so much stuff going on down here. It's amazing. She's got a whole unique store of her own.
Yeah, pretty much.
So this is
my
exciting.
Job,
it's an addiction.
Yeah.
That was the whole point. It's an addiction. It's a healthy addiction.
All right. So the first thing he's going to do is we always put our mascara in our bra. Do you know why we put our mascara in our bra?
Tell me.
To warm it up. It's 64 degrees in here.
It is cold.
So it's cold. It's quite chilly in here. And your body heat will warm it up. So that way when it's time to apply your mascara, it'll go on like a hot knife through butter.
So I'm going to just put it in my bra.
I don't think it's going to stay there.
That's my bra. My mother's watching. She would be so proud right now.
Well, you're tagged, so hopefully she'll hop
in.
She could watch the replay.
Because the joke was my great-grandmother, her grandma used to put everything in her bra.
Oh, yeah.
She'd have cash. She'd take it out and say, here, go buy yourself a soda.
I did put cash in my bra when we went to China. I made special pockets that were attached to my bra.
Safer there.
Well, yeah, we had to carry, like, that almost $10,000 in cash.
You kept $10,000. Did you do five and five?
Josh had some in his pocket too, I think.
We won't explore that any further because no need to go there, but we had $10,000 right here.
There's the most expensive
I just got. How much is this worth? What is the cost?
Of the mascara?
Mm-hmm.
24.
So I just got 24 bucks in my bra. So we're going to start here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. No, you're going to do foundation first. Mascara is usually
I'm going
like
to keep this here.
Yeah. Will it stay or should I put it in mine?
Okay. It's going to stay. Nope, it's a spell. Here it is, guys.
We'll just put it in mine.
There you go.
There we go.
All right.
It will stay there.
This is my
Pressed powder.
So
this is my go-to for foundation. It pops open like this.
Pops open.
And then you can use this to apply it, or you could use this brush right here.
I'm going to use the brush.
There you go.
I have a... What? Okay. Josh just came in. Actually, yeah, side note, Josh is going to be making us pancakes. You could maybe tune into that live later and learn how to make Josh cakes. All right, I'm going to...
Yep, swirl it on there.
I'm gonna swirl it on. This is very exciting. This is,
all right. Here we go. Actually, you're not supposed to apply your brush.
Oh,
you're not supposed to because you just put germs on my brushes. That's disgusting.
Don't ever blow your brush. Woo! It was early. Let's do it. All right, we're just gonna look at that. I'm just gonna apply gently. I'm gonna apply the powder here. Can everybody hear the Amy Winehouse playing? Because I feel like.
Oh, I'm sure they can.
You have Amy playing.
Hey, Cindy!
Hey, Cindy.
My good friend, Cindy.
Cindy, what's up?
There you go. Oh, he's gonna.
So let me ask you, Shelly, how do I know I'm doing this right?
If you can transform my face, then you're good.
Okay.
Now, I will tell you, when you use the brush instead of the sponge, mm-hmm. it'll give it more of a light coverage. If you want medium or full coverage, you want to use the little...
Well, I'm going to ask you, do you want medium?
Light coverage is fine for today.
Because this is a very light makeup tutorial. We're not going too extensive. All right. I'm going to do one more circulation just to make sure that we're covered. It's hard to really perfect perfection,
oh,
but
sure.
I think...
It's too sweet.
It's just the truth.
You're doing good so far, right?
But I feel like we're getting there.
You were about to ask the same thing. There you go. Now you know.
Oh, did...
Hi, Josh.
Did we help somebody?
Yeah.
All right, that's so I'm done. Do. I'm done
this
with
this. This is my cousin-in-law, Faye.
Hey, Faye. All right, so now what are we moving on to? What's the best next step? Once we apply...
I would probably either do highlight and contour, or I would move the eyes. It might not be the right shade. You're definitely tanner than me.
Thank you. It's because I'm from Florida, guys.
Yeah, he's a Floridian. He's loving this cold weather.
Yeah.
Sound is great. Can you hear our voices and the music? Okay.
So next step, I'm sorry, I was busy.
You can do highlight and contour, or you can do my eyes.
Let's do highlight and contour. Okay.
So I like to contour
I've
with
heard
my
about
bronzer.
This, with the Kardashians.
Oh, they're big into highlight.
Highlighting, we're gonna, and I think that's really the goal for today, is to make you look like Kim.
My favorite.
Kardashian.
My favorite highlighter is Optimistic Pressed Pigment.
I like that.
So that will go on the very tops of my cheeks and the bridge of my nose.
Okay. And then this?
This is bronzer. I like to do that in like the hollows of my cheeks.
Okay.
On the sides of my nose.
So that's going to create the depth.
Yeah. That's what makes me look like I'm 5 pounds lighter.
Okay. Which is great for a post-Christmas.
I ate a lot of food yesterday.
I think we all ate a lot of food. What was your favorite food, guys, that you ate
yesterday?
What was your favorite,
food? What's
dessert?
In your coffee? Nothing yet. Just cream and syrup.
All right.
This is all stone cold sober.
So now I can.
All right. This is my favorite brush for this. Okay. This is like, I use this brush for almost everything.
All right.
So I would do like my cheeks with this and the sides of my nose with this.
Cheeks with this, sides of the nose with this.
And so what you can do is you can feel on your cheekbone, right on your cheekbone is where your blush would go.
All right.
If you feel just underneath your bone, like right there, that's where your contour will go. And then up above is where your highlight would go.
So we're going to say right about, can everybody see that on Shelly's face here? Right about here.
Yeah. And you don't want to bring it the whole way down because we don't want to look like that.
No. So I'm just going to go like a swoop.
Yep.
All right. And how, okay, how generous do you want to be with your contouring?
Well, I like it to look like you can't really tell it's there. You know, I want
natural.
I like kind of a natural.
All right, so let's do the other side. Because I already feel like we're getting aggressive with it here.
Hey, Heather. Hey, Gretchen. No, it looks good.
Is that good?
It looks good. It looks natural. You did good.
I could have a second career as a makeup artiste.
Now, I usually do a little bit right at the top of my forehead, too.
Why?
When you get sun, the sun hits, especially when you have a big forehead.
Do you guys get sun here in Pennsylvania?
We do.
The same sun that we get in Florida?
I don't think it's quite as intense.
Oh, my God.
But it just kind of adds, when you put foundation on, you lose all of that depth.
Oh,
on
okay.
Your face, so you want to put some of it back on.
Okay.
Okay.
So this looks good.
And
so
then the
far.
Side of my nose.
Oh, the side of your, and we're gonna use
the small side of the highlight contour brush.
Right. Yep.
And I just do like right along the side of your nose.
And so that thins
it
out.
It makes it look thinner. Mm. Yeah.
Shelly, you're a really good teacher.
Oh, thank you.
How long have you been doing this? It's been a couple years now,
it's
right?
It's been, March will be 2 years.
Wow. And you learned everything?
Just by watching others.
Yeah. Amazing.
And then, let's see, we have a couple different brushes you can choose from.
Does anybody have any blush suggestions?
We have Sweet.
Sweet.
Yes, it is as what it is when Josh did. I think my makeup will probably turn out a little bit better because Josh wasn't seeing. This is
Josh
the blush that Josh
talented.
Broke when he did my makeup.
What was he doing?
He was sitting behind me doing my makeup. So he was my arms, kind of like a T-Rex.
Yeah.
He couldn't see what he was doing. And he got angry at my blush, so he threw it. And it broke apart. And so I used alcohol.
Why
did
you take it out on the blush?
I know.
What did the blush ever
And this
do?
Was my favorite blush, too. So, but I fixed it. I used alcohol. My friend told me to use alcohol. And I drank like a bottle of wine. And it still wasn't fixed.
I don't know what's happening to you guys.
It's still not fixed.
It's still broken.
She's like, no, you got to put the alcohol in the blush.
In the blood.
So
that's a note for everybody out there. You can't,
rubbing alcohol, not
you
wine.
Can't chug it. You got to use it.
And then it
and then chug it.
And then it evaporates. So that's all fixed.
All right.
That is supported. And then this one's spirited. So you get to pick a blush. Pick a blush.
I'm going
to
go. I want to use.
These have shimmers.
I want to use your favorite. It was this
supported,
one.
The one that's broken.
So if nobody can actually see what Josh did.
Yeah, it was in pieces all over the place. Like I had to pull out Belle's fur and
that looks like
it was a mess.
That looks like something went really wrong here. All right, so what brush?
I would use this brush.
Same brush.
Same brush, it's my favorite brush.
Okay. And so this is just gonna highlight.
You only need a little bit. That's super, I should have told you it's super pigmented. That's gonna go on really light. So if you want to dust it off a little bit.
Oh, no, we're good.
Oh, okay.
We're good.
And then it goes right on the top. It's there.
Okay,
it's
right here.
Bright.
Oh, yeah, that's bright. It's got some Christmas spirit.
Oh, 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 oh.
Maybe even a little bit more.
Oh,
I don't think so. All right.
I lost my mirror again.
Oh, wow, it's great.
Great.
I love how, first of all, I love the mission of Unique. It's about empowering
yes.
women, correct?
Mm-hmm. How did you get blush on my chin?
It was intentional. I wanted to give you that Florida sunburn.
Yeah, that's where I was getting burnt.
This is turning out really nice, guys.
And then highlight.
Okay, same brush.
Same brush.
Other side.
I would do that for my nose,
okay.
But I do use the big side for up here because I like that.
Should I cleanse this?
Yeah, I would. You can swirl it in that. If you want to wash it, wash it. We have an instant. We do have an instant brush cleaner too, which will get that back to white. The way
how much is the instant brush cleaner?
$19.
That's a great deal.
Yes. So we use Optimistic Pressed Pigment.
Did everybody see that? Optimistic Pressed Pigment.
This is my monster palette. Cindy loves my monster palette.
And so now where are we going with this?
Very tops of my cheeks.
Very tops.
This is going to make us shine bright like a diamond.
Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond.
You're going to see us from outer space.
That's Rihanna, guys. That's Rihanna. And Shelly Keller. Can you sing that for us, actually?
Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond.
There we go.
And then usually, whatever's left over in the brush is when I do my nose, or you can use a small side to do
it. I feel like
nose.
You still need, there we go.
All right. You want to amp it up?
Yeah, let's amp it.
You could use, where are we hiding?
Okay.
Oh, there it is.
Are we cross-contaminating? Oh, I took a shower.
That's okay. I didn't.
I took a shower today, guys.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, Josh. I didn't realize you could like, see what everybody's saying.
You are hired.
Cindy is rolling right now. Well, that's exciting. You might want to ground yourself a little bit. And Josh says you're hired. So I have a makeup career.
Yay!
Does Unique take men?
Yes. Oh. We have two men presenters right now.
Oh, good to know. Yeah.
This is another highlighter. This is a cream to powder luminizer.
Okay.
If you want to
use
that.
We can just paint that right on. Shelly.
Paint that right on there.
I just kind of, can everybody really see what's happening on Shelly's face right now? I feel like I could probably take this home. I really have faith.
I have faith in myself.
And us as a team. All right, so this is just gonna go right here. I got your hair in there. Oh, yes. I feel like, I'm gonna sell this right now. I feel like every person who applies makeup should have this.
The luminizer?
Yeah.
And that one is
for sure.
Lustrous, I think, the color's on the bottom.
Lustrous. This is beautiful.
Isn't it pretty?
Wow.
And then do the bridge of my nose, too.
That's this, right?
Mm-hmm.
I gotta ask what the bridge of your nose is. How about just your forehead?
I love that big.
No, that's beautiful. Now you're just shining bright like a diamond. And this is lustrous.
It's like a rose gold. I don't know the price of those offhand. So. Okay. He has way more fun than you.
So now we can move on to eyes.
Yeah, I would totally do eyes.
The window of the soul.
Yeah. Now, Cindy, if you're still on, tell me, what should he use as a base for my eyes?
Cindy?
See who really watches.
Cindy there.
Little Cindy Lou Who. And we would do brows too.
Okay.
Okay. Victoria's Cream Shadow. I always use this as a base, just like we put foundation on my face to kind of rub
it in. So this is a base for your eyes.
This is what I like to use for my eyes.
Can I just take a second? I feel like this is a Christmas miracle that I'm here right now. This is so exciting.
You are highlighting like crazy. You should see this.
I'm shining bright like a diamond. Okay, back. Let's get serious.
My favorite, I use my ring finger and apply it to my eyes. It'll cover up my veins that you see in my eyes and the redness that I have.
What's any veins in your eyes?
If I'm sleepy looking under here, you can apply it under my eyes as a concealer.
Okay.
It'll just make me look bright. Don't worry.
So this finger.
Yeah. Or you can use the cream shadow brush. Totally up to you.
I'm just going to finger.
Somebody's not happy.
Yet. Yeah, I
Victoria,
hear crying
right,
babies
Cindy,
out there. So like here?
Yep, all over my eyes.
Oh, we're gonna hit this hard, guys.
That way, when you apply the shadows,
going in.
The color is gonna be true to color.
Shelly says she has veins that this is covering up in her eyes. I don't see any, and I'm really up in here right now.
You see those wrinkles?
I don't see any wrinkles. And if I did, I wouldn't say anything.
Because you're a good boy.
Because they're feeding me today.
No pancakes for you.
Yeah, really. I'm so excited for the pancakes after this. All right. How do I know I've completely concealed? A little bit. A little bit right there. I see that. I see the difference, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got a little
Sometimes
bit more.
It's hard to get close to the lash line.
There we go.
Especially when you're putting on somebody else.
Take that on. All right.
Well, we can blend it out. If you give it a second, it'll dry to like a powder,
okay.
And you can just blend it out. The key to good eyeshadow application is blending.
I love that little side tip.
Okay. Have you decided what shadow you're going to do? Let's do my brows before you do my eyeshadow. because the brows are just bringing the focus right back to my eyes. What do you want to use for my brows?
Okay, this part makes me nervous.
Okay.
So they have to be symmetrical.
They are sisters, and they need to look like twins.
Okay, I so, like that.
Yeah, so what I use sisters is I use my...
I have twins, actually.
Yeah. And they don't look exactly alike.
They don't. Well,
right?
One's a boy, one's a girl. Yes. So there's some big differences right there.
I use my Brow Artist Holy Brush. Okay. So I'll give you that. And then it's up to you. Do you want to use the brow pencil or do you want to use my Faithful Cream Shadow?
I'm going to use the pencil.
It'll be a little bit easier.
Yeah.
You might not need that brush then, though, because this one has its own spoolie.
Perfect.
Okay.
So that I just.
So what you want to do first. Brush my brow.
Is everybody taking notes here? Because I feel like there's a lot of gold in this live feed right now.
Is it's
everybody...
on your cheeks. The gold is all on your cheeks right there. You guys cannot see this.
All right.
First
my
thing you want to do.
Running.
Tissues are right behind you. And I'm going to take the coffee sip.
Sorry, this is disgusting. That's
I'm
what
sure.
this weather does.
I'm sure I've done pretty cursed things on camera too. What I like to do when I do my brows, some people go basically create their own brows.
Okay.
I like to follow what my natural brow is.
Right.
So I brush my brows down,
okay,
and I follow the hairline on both sides, and then I brush them up.
So you're brushing it with this?
Yep, the little spoolie.
So down,
yep,
follow,
the line,
and then brush it up.
Yep. And if you want to create your own brows, which you probably are nuts. No, what you want to do is use your brush. If
okay.
you're if you don't have brows and you want to kind of create your own, you put the brush along the side of your nose and the center of your eyes. That's where your brow should start.
Can I see that?
That's where your brow should start.
Because I listen, I'm gonna do a little behind the scenes Ryan tip. Not tip at all. Actually, I'm looking for a tip. So I pluck my brows very lightly.
Yeah.
But I never really know what to do. And
yeah.
I've seen on TV, they said you go by the pupil of your eye and then you draw a line up
mm-hmm.
for like the natural kind of
arch.
Angle.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't want it to look overly.
So here's another tip for your arch. So you, this is where your brow should start. So make sure you're not plucking out too far.
Okay.
Because I know if you have some here, you want to get that. But you
yeah.
want to make sure that you don't come fast. That. Okay.
Gotcha.
And then for your arch, you line. Let me get my mirror so I can make sure I'm doing it right. You line the side of your nose to where was it? To your pupil. Okay? That's where your natural arch would be.
Okay.
And then it's the same on the other side to your pupil. Okay? And then where your brow should end, you line the side of your nose and the side of your eye. And that's where your brow should end.
Wow.
And you see how wacky this brow is?
Uh-huh.
Look how it like grows and then it like goes like this.
Yeah.
So I like cut it and then I just draw mine.
Okay.
Okay. But this one comes the whole way.
So basically, we have everything we need as a template
yeah.
right in our eye.
Yep.
What do you think about my eyebrows, everybody?
I think they look good. What do you guys think of his brows?
Let me know.
Hey, Katie. Hey, Wanda.
Do they need some help?
Madison.
Or are we good? I mean, they're manly eyebrows. They're good. You can write that in the comments below. All right. So we're going to go hard. Let's do it.
Brush down. Yep.
We're going to brush down.
And I have very thin, light eyebrows.
Shelly does have thin brows,
yeah.
guys.
And I hardly ever pluck them anymore.
But we're going to thicken them up today.
What happens is if you pluck your brows too much, eventually they won't come back in. So make sure you don't over pluck them.
Good to know. So now, if
and
I want to start drawing.
The pencil's on the other side. And it,
this twists.
Yeah, like this. Up and down.
Oh, wow. Okay. Oops. All right, I'm just gonna freeform this.
And what I do is just short brush strokes to mimic
so
hair.
So it looks natural.
Okay. Yeah.
I just went a little low, but that's okay.
Right, because then you're gonna go back and fill it in anyway.
Oh wow, this is, don't take notes on how I'm drawing on eyebrows, people. Okay.
Do we need a shine cloth?
No, I think we're just going to go for it.
Go with it.
I'm thinking about the moms who out there who need to do this quick. They might not be able to take time to shine cloth, whatever that means.
That's what I used to wash my
suit. Oh. All right.
Not horrible! Not horrible. Seriously, it's not horrible, right?
Okay. You know what? If I'm doing this to Shelly,
you would want the dark.
Oh, to myself.
All right. Have a good day, Cindy.
Bye, Cindy Lou. Love you.
I thought you were going to put it away. I was like, I have two brows.
She has two brows. It's so weird. Shelly has two eyebrows. Like, what's happening in the world today, guys? All right. I love this song. Do you like Amy Winehouse?
I don't know if I ever heard her.
Well, you're hearing her right now.
Yeah, well, I like the sound.
She's pretty amazing. She's unfortunately no longer with us.
Oh.
But a true artist, much like you and I. All right.
And then you'll brush up and line underneath and then fill in.
I feel like...
You got it. You're good. Yeah.
I feel like it's not terrible.
No, it's not terrible.
For a first stab at it, so yeah. I'm going to brush up.
Yep. And then just make sure you have the line underneath. And generally, your brows will be thicker at the front and then thinner at the end.
Okay.
And the nice thing, too, is if you have some areas that you feel like you applied too thick, use that spoolie brush and just keep brushing and it'll get lighter.
Let's brush a little bit. All right, guys, what do you think?
I think you did good.
Okay. We'll put this
one
here.
Okay, could you remove the other end too?
I lost a lot of stuff. I mean, if you could see what's on my lap right now.
It's got all of my brushes down.
You guys are like watching this safe.
Oh, you know you have the one
in your house. And I've got stuff all over the place.
It's okay.
All right.
You should see it. When I'm done with my lives, there's stuff like everywhere. And I'm like, okay. I need to clean up.
Really?
Like,
she's got a killer operation going on here. Let's do the eye shadow.
Okay. What do you want?
You know, I want that blue that I saw.
Oh, I thought maybe so.
I want that blue. My favorite color is blue. It's this blue right here.
I think I've worn that blue once.
And how was that day? That I bet you got so many compliments that day that you wore the blue. And you're going to get so many compliments today.
That's if I go out in public.
You're going to go out in public with this. Right? Why is she? She's not answering. Right?
We'll see what the finished product looks like.
Okay, okay. So what am I using brush-wise?
That's totally up to you.
These blacks are very nice, too.
Yeah. I like using them as eyeliners.
Hello?
Hey, bud.
We have a visitor.
All right. So some of my go-to favorite brushes.
Okay.
This is a crease brush. This is one I use to add dimension in like the outer corner.
Okay. Do I want to use a darker color there?
Normally.
To add dimension.
Mm-hmm. And then this is a liner.
Can I go from
brush.
This one to this one?
You can do whatever you want.
I can do whatever I want.
If you want just a light transition color.
Nope.
Or I think we're going to need this brush a lot. This is called a blending brush.
Okay.
Blend it out, make it not look so crazy.
So I'm going to start with the dark color, right?
Okay, if you want.
Okay.
And these are just magnetic, so if you wanted to hold it.
Oh, sweet.
This is called cynical.
Cynical, so which is pretty much what most people call me. So that's appropriate. All right, I'm going to take some cynical. Do I blow?
No, tap. There you go.
All right. There we go. I'm going to go right in there.
That's it. If you have a hooded eye and you go just in your crease, when I open my eye, watch this. It's going to disappear.
Bam.
You don't see it anymore.
Bam.
Yes, you do see that. There is
God,
no hiding this
so
one.
Good.
There's no hiding this
she
one.
She looks beautiful. Beautiful. I'm going to apply some more. All right.
Lord help me.
The Lord's all over this, okay?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Actually, I'm glad that we're listening to Amy right now, Amy Winehouse, because I feel like we can maybe aspire for a little of her makeup technique.
Oh, blend. You can use that blending brush if
which
you want
is
to
the blending?
It.
This
it's
one.
The fluffy. Nope. really, really fluffy.
All right. Got a hand of brushes and some cynical. You're quite talented. Is there a technique to blending?
Usually what you want to do is hold the brush more like at the end.
Okay.
And just lightly windshield wiper back and forth.
Gotcha.
Nice light handing. Unless you really want to remove the color.
I don't want to remove the color. All right, guys. I feel like this video, this live, could go viral, and all the millennials are going to want, I think the Kardashians are going to pretty much take inspiration from this video. What do you guys think?
How many times does she have to tell you don't blow the brush?
Josh, I like to blow the brush. So inappropriate.
Bring it to Josh to bring it back.
Josh!
And Joshua!
God, make the pancakes,
Josh.
Make the pancakes.
He's supposed to teach you how to make
pancakes. Yeah, I'm supposed to learn how to make pancakes. I didn't know today, Shelly. This is going to be such a an informative and educational morning. It's early. We just got our first cup of coffee in, and I've already learned how to do makeup. And next is on to
the kitchen. It is 10:30. It's not terribly early anymore. It's all good. This one, I think, is called Thankful.
Oh.
Is that what it is?
It is.
Thankful.
This is called Thankful.
I'm really thankful I have that color available for Ryan to use this morning.
I am too.
You probably want to use this brush for that.
Because
you're not going in my crease, right?
I don't.
You have no idea where you're going with it.
Josh, you can take that wherever you want. All right. So I'm going to go here.
And that is like a metallic finish.
It's interesting. It's way brighter on here.
Then it's showing up on my eyes?
Yeah.
If you really want to intensify the color, which we probably don't, you can use an eye primer.
Are you speaking for me or for you on that? Probably
so. Or, watch this handy little trick. Let me grab my setting spray, which is just about empty. Spray your brush.
So Shelly says, and I love this idea, we're not going to do it today, but if we want a more intense color, we can do an eye
primer.
Wow, that looks rough on camera.
So if you wet your brush.
If anybody wants me to come over and do their makeup, I'm practically an expert now. So I'll give my phone number at the end of this.
He's only in Pennsylvania one more day, though.
So I'll book on demand.
Okay. Now try going back over with that now and see if it makes it more intense.
Wow, it really does.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. So what is that?
You can use setting spray
magic
or rose
juice?
Water. This is called setting spray. This is usually what I spray on my face when I'm done to help it stay. Sweat.
So I've seen you post pictures. You can cry. Why would you be crying?
Well, I don't know.
I've seen you post pictures of you after the beach, or not the beach, the pool, and everything is perfectly...
That's amazing.
No.
That's blue.
That's very blue. I went a little higher than I anticipated. Kind of got like a working girl.
Is that like a Mimi thing going
Melanie Griffith, 1984-85. But you know what, Shelly?
Such is life.
Life throws us surprises and we gotta rock it. And we have some children visitors, and I think we might horrify them.
Oh, they went back.
Oh, no, they ran away.
They ran away. They brought gingerbread.
They brought the dog in. They saw mom. They ran out. All right.
Okay.
So now we're going to do eyeliner.
Okay.
And I want to go full on Amy Winehouse, cat eye. I'm going to throw back the hat for that one.
First, do me a favor and wash your brush.
I'm going to wash my brush.
Okay, so you want to use this cloth right here? Show them how blue that is. I want to make sure the next time I use this brush, the color I'm wearing is on and not the blue. So this is our brush cleaner.
I was cleaning the brush with my face.
There you go, that works too. So you just give it a couple spritzes. And now wipe it on the cloth. Just brush back and forth. And you keep doing that and keep going. And then with science, it'll be immediately ready to use.
That's amazing.
Okay. Well, look at this one.
These are great products.
Guys, this is supposed to be white.
It's not looking white. So currently, Shelly's cleaning the brush on my lap. Again, what you can't see is rather exciting.
But look, what color is it now?
That is a white brush!
Isn't that crazy?
Oh my god!
Yeah, so we're gonna make sure that.
Keep your hats up, folks, we got a white brush!
That way they will be ready to go next time. I'm not always the best at washing my brushes. If I brush my brushes in the sink, it takes me like 30 to 45 minutes.
I'm gonna pull up an inspiration picture.
Oh. All right. There we go.
Because I feel like the eyeliner is very important.
Yes.
All right. Can everybody see? We're gonna try to go a little cool cat eye.
Is that her?
That's Amy.
Beautiful.
She's beautiful. What?
Okay. So he's going to attempt to use our dip and draw eyeliner, which, guys, this lasts at least 18 hours.
Wow. What do they do to make it last that long?
I have no idea. But when you use them, you want to hear that rattle ball?
Shake
in
it.
There?
It's like you're shaking up some spray paint.
Yeah, pretty much.
This is not spray paint.
There's the tip.
Okay.
Okay. When I'm doing my dip and draw eyeliner, I start in the center, like right above my pupil, and draw out, and then go back in, so that way there's less product going for the inside.
Okay.
Because you want it to be thinner on the inside and thicker on the outside, especially when you're pulling something like that.
Yeah.
Like you want it to be out here.
Okay.
Okay? And then you just dip it back in, and you need more.
You gotta dip it low.
I always suggest steadying your hands on something.
Oh, geez.
So when I do it, I like have my hand here, and then my other one here, or rest my finger on part of my face, or something like that.
I'm just gonna steady my hand on
Shelly. You can put your pinky like on the.
Good thing I have the
face.
Serenity prayer on my arm, right? This is perfect. All right. Oh, wow, guys, I think everybody should use this. This is quite beautiful.
Do you know the tip for? Of course, I think it feels like you're getting the wing of it.
I like I'm getting the wing of it. But is there a tip that you can give?
Normally.
Because everybody might not be as advanced as me.
Yeah, you are natural.
And then you need to re-dip.
Yeah, normally I need to dip. So normally what I do when I'm creating a cat eye or a wing, however big or small.
I can't get it in the hole.
You want to picture an imaginary line.
Where? No, oh my. Woo, crazy feed today.
So usually you want to picture an imaginary line from the outer corner of your eye to your eyebrow, so your wing is like up here, which really opens your eyes and make them look like wider.
So I gotta go taller with it, like up.
Wow. Yeah. Because
was that a good wow, Shelly? I feel like she's not being totally honest with me right now.
It's great.
That's what family's for. Okay. So I'm going to now take Shelly's amazing advice, and I'm going to go a little higher with it. Oh, okay. So if this had been done right,
worry,
I get what she's
eye.
Saying. I get what she's saying. Hey, Rebecca Massey. Amy is the best. Rebecca, I could have done your makeup at your wedding. I don't know why you didn't call me for that.
Totally.
looks really bad on camera, guys.
I mean, it doesn't look better in person.
It doesn't look much better in person, but I thought maybe like it would look a little bit better on the camera.
It the doesn't. Camera does not tell lies.
Well, sometimes it does.
Okay, not this one.
Not this camera.
You see it all.
This is the truth. Let's just move on to the next one. Okay. Should I go for the lower?
No, I don't. Normally when I do eyeliner on the lower lash, I'll use my pencil.
Oh, okay. All right, so I'm going to go higher to open up the eye. Yes, or Rebecca, you should have hired me to do the makeup bigger one, for sure.
If he does your makeup, I'll hide the gifted. Or the thankful, I'll hide the thankful blue for you.
Shelly, I'm getting this one.
Awesome.
Oh, wait, should I shake it still?
No, you don't need to after it's open. Yeah, just before you use it. I will tell you, Ryan must be good because I've gotten this in my eyes already before. That does not feel so good, and he hasn't gotten any in my eyes.
Oh, censored! All right. Thank you for that acknowledgement.
Mm-hmm. It burns like a dickens when you get it in your eyes. Well, thank you for not getting it in my eyes.
I'm trying.
No, you're Ryan.
I'm trying and I'm Ryan. Hey, just a little bit more and then I think we're good. Just a little bit. You said dinner in
yeah,
here.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, we need to even that out a little bit.
A little bit.
Huh, just right down here. Such a baby.
Totally joking. I was gonna play that out a little bit.
Okay. Really just for how good this looks. All right, what do you think? Is this a winner?
All right, I think you need to add the black eyeliner underneath.
Okay.
Because I mean, if you're going for like a crazy bold smoky eye.
Oh, I dropped my brushes.
Excuse me. I have just a few brushes.
Okay, I am nervous about that. I'm very nervous about taking this sharp object to your eye.
Normally I would do it on my waterline, but we're gonna go ahead and not let
on
you
the
do that.
Outside.
Just go right under.
Okay.
Steady that hand.
Everybody who is watching, all five of you.
We'll get lots of replays.
Can you please say a silent prayer as I go to Shelly's eyeball?
I had eye surgery once. I don't want to
with
do
a
it
pencil.
Again.
We don't want a second eye surgery. Drink that coffee. Do you want a shot of tequila?
No, I'm good.
Okay. We're doing it. I love you. Thank you for trusting me. We're just lining that eye. Oh. Okay.
I wasn't going to talk because I didn't want you to poke my
okay.
eye.
Okay.
Good.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I think that was good. And you still have your eye.
Yeah. Okay, one more.
Shelly has really beautiful, like, ocean blue eyes, like the Bahama eyes. I was just in the Bahamas the other day.
Oh.
And the water is the color of your eyes. Hmm. Just a little.
Some days they look green. They change.
She's got, like, mood eyes.
Yep.
Oh, I just gave you a little Marilyn. Dot. That's your Monroe.
Silent and loud prayer.
You just gotta go where the inspiration takes you, guys. You don't want to stay caged into a box with your makeup.
Right.
Some days you're feeling a little Marilyn. You didn't know when you woke up that you were gonna feel that way.
Yep.
Oh, I went a little low. It's harder on the other.
Mm-hmm.
Eye.
It's the placement of your hand.
Yeah, well, that definitely looks different. But for the sake of our seven viewers, we're going to hold off on adding more. But I feel like I need to just join you. I used to put on eyeliner a little bit in high school, and I thought it looked really cool.
Were you like the goth?
I wasn't goth, but like
the black nails and such.
I did. I wanted to be, but I was more just kind of like sad and like emo.
This look does not look sad.
No, that look that you're working right
quite
now, that look looks like
it's merry and bright.
You're the coolest girl in town. Oh, that's sad. Looks like you're the coolest girl in town. All right.
You know, when Ryan first said that he was going to do my makeup, I was worried that it was going to be like a hot mess and I'd have to wash it all off. But this is like professional grade. I'm definitely going to wear this all day.
Maybe we should do like a unique tour and go out into the public and do this.
Here we go.
So next is lips, right?
Yes. If you want, you can finish with mascara first.
Oh, yes.
Sometimes I do lips, then mascara. Sometimes I do mascara, then lips. There's no rules.
Get the eyes done.
Okay.
I can't handle it.
I'll go ahead.
I look really sad. I look like...
Stay for a second.
Did you ever...
You can't do the ugly cry with this makeup. I'm sorry.
Oh, because it stays on. It's
yeah,
so good.
It's amazing. If you want the ugly cry, makeup. You got to go to the drugstore.
Did you ever see that movie... The wedding movie with Kate Hudson. Never mind. Anyway, she looks like this at one point. It rains on her. The makeup's coming all down. Her hair was dyed blue accidentally. That's what I feel.
Wow.
All right.
Now, don't pump your mascara because that'll put air in it and then it'll dry it out.
So like, do this
yeah,
with it?
Like some people go and they like pump it. And you don't want to do that.
We're not going to pump our mascara.
And we'll go ahead and skip the curling of the lashes. Normally I curl my lashes.
We're just gonna
we'll skip that.
Fan them out. I like that you no instruction on the mascara. I'm just going for it. Oh god, I got a clump. What do you do if there's a clump? We got a full on clump, guys. I think everybody who does mascara.
I've never gotten a clump like this. Dang, boy.
Well, I wanted to show our viewers what happens when you get a clump.
Okay, well, when it's that big, you just use your thumb and pull it off.
Like a piece of dude.
Or you use a pencil and go through.
All right.
I think I got it out.
So back to. I think that eye's good.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. All right.
What if I turn my face a little bit more?
Yeah. Wow, this mascara goes on. Oh,
I do my bottom lashes too. Yeah. Now, with my old drugstore mascara, I wouldn't because I would have that ugly cry by the end of the day.
It makes me so nervous to like approach your eyes. Okay.
Wiggle back and forth. There you go.
Oh, wiggle back and forth on the bottom lashes, guys.
You got it, right?
Oh, boy. All right. All right.
Yeah, I usually just kind of like rest the wand on there and wiggle it back and forth and pull it out. And that's okay. Let's see. Not too bad.
She's not horrified, guys. At this point, I think Shelly's just used to what's going on in her face.
I'm delirious.
Okay.
All right. And you're going to pick a lipstick.
I'm going to pick a lipstick.
If you want, you can have the viewers help you choose.
Okay.
Which I didn't show you these colors. I have a feeling there's a color in here that you just would love. It's called Swagger.
Ooh, I like this one.
Oh, yeah. That's a break.
This is pretty. Do you have a black?
I do not have black. Oh, yeah.
We got... What does everybody think about sizzling? It's very bright. Or, what's this called?
Oh, it fell off. I don't remember the name of that one.
Or this one. Ooh. All right, Shelly. I think we're going to just go with that. What is the name of this lipstick?
How about this one? This is called Swagger. I was so intimidated by this lipstick.
Why?
Because it's bold.
What did it do to you?
Right.
The lipstick do that it intimidated you.
Well, it's a bold lip. Yeah. But every time I saw it, it was so pretty. I was like, what color are you wearing? And every time it was Swagger.
Did you feel like you had Swagger?
Oh, yeah.
Most importantly, big pimpin'. All right. So at what point can Olivia come? Olivia is my 19-month-old daughter. When can she start getting her makeup done?
I thought for you.
It kind of matches her headband.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to call this, instead of Swagger, Unique Purple. I'm going to put that in right now to the...
Isn't that a pretty color, though?
It is beautiful.
Yeah, Swagger.
So,
you
Shelly.
Did pretty good putting it on my lips, I must say. That's
thank you.
Not an easy thing to do. The last time the kids did my lipstick, it's like all over my face.
So, let's take a moment... and reflect. First of all, you look beautiful.
Thanks.
Shelly.
Nice lips.
Actually, it's not going anywhere, is it?
No, it'll stay for a little while.
All right.
It does kiss off, though.
Oh, it kisses off.
There's transfer to it.
We're not doing that, guys.
No.
Get it out of your head. So, how do you feel about your look and my first makeup experience?
Well, I want to hear what they think. What do you guys think? How did he do?
I don't know. Nobody's saying anything. Are they really watching?
I think they're terrified.
Is anybody out
there? I think they're in the corner going, oh my God, what did they do to Shelly? What did he do?
It's still Shelly, guys. It's just
still me.
Shelly transformed to this. Actually, what would this name be?
Trainwreck.
Oh, okay.
Christmas Madness. I think this is totally Christmas.
No,
Madness.
I think I'm saying, though, if this was your alter ego, who would this be? Shelly versus. Oh, Rebecca's trying to respond.
Trying. Not bad. Oh, Josh is not bad.
Josh.
He didn't see it in person.
You're
yet,
married
love.
To Shelly. So, in case anybody didn't know, and in case he didn't know, Josh, you're married to Shelly. What would her alter ego be called? Whoever this is, I think she comes out sometimes, right? Who is this? Oh, Robin. Robin thinks you look gorgeous.
Yay.
Robin, I think you're
like
gorgeous.
This is a neat touch.
The I'm mole like
the
edition.
Maryland, the Mar- I mean, because I have my own down here, but sometimes it hides. So I like that right up there.
And I think it like balance.
Yeah.
Is it here?
Yeah.
No, it's on this side. I think it helps balance out. Rebecca,
yes, he did not,
I did not
my
poke
eyes
your eyes out.
Yes, he did good.
They're clearly still in your head. Oh, Josh said you'd just be called Supermom looking like this.
Supermom.
That was loving. All right, guys.
All
well,
right.
I got to just tell you, I'm very honored to be able to sit in this chair.
Thank you.
Be able to do your face.
Just so y'all know, all this craziness was Ryan's idea.
I don't,
showed up and
oh,
he's
please,
like, so
you
are we? Yeah, I did. You're right. I totally did. All right, please do my makeup.
She did. I begged. I was like, please let me do your makeup. I didn't. We don't know what happened.
He didn't have to beg.
We don't know how this happened.
You did pretty good, though, for your first time.
Thank you so much.
You have lipstick all over your face, though. I don't know how you see has it, like, down here. I don't think you guys can see it. But... Got it.
Another.
Now you're giving him the finger.
Oh.
I used my ring finger.
I'm so sorry, guys. This is our parting tip. You can play good, but use this finger so you're not flicking everybody off. It's awful.
All right. Well, I hope you guys have today's Wednesday, right? A wonderful Wednesday. If you enjoyed or maybe learned something new or got a laugh out of this video, click that share button.
I learned
at the bottom.
A lot of new things.
Go tell the kids to clean their room. Don't hurry. Don't clean your room.
Supermom is going to come out and you do not want to mess with Supermom. You better clean that room.
Oh my gosh. The lipstick looks good with your beard. All right.
Thank you.
Keep you away from Josh. You can't go in the kitchen.
We're going to bake pancakes now. You bake pancakes?
No, you cook pancakes.
That'll be tutorial number two.
Yes. All right.
Bye, everybody.
Chat with you guys soon. Have a great day.
See you later.
Toodaloo. Oh, that was fun.